Hello, I'm Dr. Barbara Golder, and welcome to this weekly podcast entitled Decoded. We're so excited to be able to bring this programming to you. Today's edition is called Fear Factor, and we're going to talk to you about some things that are quite mind-provoking and intriguing. The purpose of this particular podcast is to debunk and to expose some of the things that have become popular in our culture today. We'll discuss current affairs, we'll discuss world affairs, we'll discuss school affairs, we'll discuss church affairs, literally anything that concerns people. We are going to talk about it, and we're going to try to decode truth from lie. And so tell your friends, tell your neighbors, tell your loved ones to join us, because they won't want to miss this show every Friday at 8 p.m. Hosea 4 and 6 says, "My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God. I will also forget thy children." That's deep right there. I don't know about you, but the children do not need to be forgotten. I don't want the Lord to forget my children. The children need God. And so we've got to make sure that we're not compromising truth for lie so that the children can be blessed. This program is designed to literally empower us with knowledge. And so submit your questions. Feel free to submit your comments and your topics. If you have questions or concerns or even subject matter that you'd like discussed, submit that to our address. It's on the screen, decodedknowledge@aol.com. Again, that is decodedknowledge@aol.com. We'd love to hear from you. We invite everyone to join us. However, these sessions are really strategically positioned to bless the young people, just to help them understand some of the spirits that are surrounding the things that they're going through today. I'd like to introduce to you now a couple of our show producers. These ladies work very hard, Liz Word and Stephanie Pinkney. Both of them are Decoded producers. They are the ones that dig deep. They get the facts. They bring them to me. They get the subject matter of what's going on today in our society. They bring it to me so that we can decode it and come to you every week with facts. So, hey, Liz, you want to say hey to everybody?
Hope you enjoyed the show.
All right. Thank you, Liz. Thank you. She works very hard. And then Stephanie. Hey there, Steph.
Hey, hey, everybody. So happy to see you guys here. It's going to be an awesome time. Make sure you get your friends and your family in the chats every Friday to discuss our topics.
Yes, do that. Do that. You know, we chose Fear Factor as our topic for this month because, of course, we're in the month of October, and everybody knows this is Halloween month. And I mean, they kick off the month with new scary movies. Every time you turn around, it's another scary movie. And so there's some really popular movies out right now. I don't watch them. I never have really liked scary movies because of the way they make me feel. But there's some popular ones out, and a lot of people love scary movies. Even the saints love scary movies. And so we want to see a few clips of some of the more popular scary movies, and then we're going to bring on our guests. So Stephanie, set up the clips for us.
No problem. So the first clip you guys are going to see is from a movie called Night Books. Night Books is actually a fantasy family horror movie. It's about a young boy named Alex who is obsessed with scary stories. He has to tell a spine-tickling tale every night or stay trapped in his new friend Yasmin's wicked apartment forever. Take a look.
Where am I? Hello?
Is there any reason I should let you live?
I write scary stories.
I'm going to need a story every night, or it's the last thing you'll ever do.
Wow. Okay. That's why I don't look at scary movies. That thing right there sent chills. And using the little child to portray, you know, this poor little character that likes scary movies and books, and now, you know, his life is threatened if he don't keep engaging. Yep. Oh man, that's crazy. And so you're saying this is one of the most popular movies that are out now?
Yes, on Netflix is one of the most popular movies. People are loving this movie because the child is so engaging with having to write these scary stories.
Yeah.
And they see it as entertainment.
Wow. Okay. No, not me. Let's go to the next one. What else you got for us?
So the next movie is called Resident Evil Raccoon City. And it is about a booming home of pharmaceutical giant Umbrella Corporation. Raccoon City is now a dying Midwestern town. The company's exodus left the city a wasteland with great evil brewing below the surface. When the evil is unleashed, the town people are forever changed, and a small group of survivors, they're trying to work together to turn Umbrella Town and make it through the night.
All right, let's see what you got.
Let's see.
What the?
Down.
No.
Woo! You see all that blood?
Resident Evil.
Woo! Yeah, that one
so,
got me.
Oh. I don't get it. And that's why I'm so glad we've got these guests on today. Yes. To just come and help us to understand what's entertaining about evil. To come on and help us to understand the pleasure that they get out of this. And they're not the only ones, because these movies are box office hits. Horror movies are box office hits. And so we just need to see why people like stuff like this. So without any further ado, we're going to bring our guest on today. We've got two young people that I am so happy to have on. Caden Briggs, who is from Indianapolis, Indiana. I've known her since she was a baby, since before she was a baby. And now she's grown up, preteen. And we also have Michaela Smith on, a very sweet young lady who hails all the way from Atlanta, Georgia. Welcome to both of you. It's so good to have you on as our guest. So good to have you. Welcome, Caden.
Hi.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good. Listen, I'm gonna start with you. I know that that you like scary movies, right?
Yes.
Okay, I need to get in your mind for a minute. I need to get all up in your head, if you don't mind. What is it that you like about scary movies? What does it do for you?
Well, I just like the tension of it, you know? Like,
okay.
Let's say, so Halloween's Kill or another movie, a horror movie, a girl's about to die, but we don't know that yet. So we're like, is she going to die or is she going to live? You know, just like the tension. I just love the tension.
So you love the tension of the scary movie.
Yes.
And somebody getting ready to die excites you. Come on, I'm breaking it down now. You know what? It's my job to play the devil's advocate, to really get down in your head. So that excites you. Okay, so Michaela, you know what's the thrill for you? You like scary movies, right?
I do like scary movies.
Okay. Tell me what the thrill is.
I think I can agree with Kaden, like just the thought of like, what's gonna happen next? You know, like it's like that whole build up moment. Like, and then also for me, like the different evil characters that they have in the scary movies. I always think about like, let me think of an example, like Halloween, like with Michael Myers, like his whole backstory and all of that. I'm just like, what is in this man's mind to possess him to even want to do these things or even harm people? And it's just like, when you sit there and you think about it, it's just like, this is very intriguing, to, if I can be 100% honest. And just that by itself, it's just like, nah, I got to keep watching this. I got to see what's going to happen next, because obviously dude's got a couple screws loose, but I want to see how far he goes with this. I want to see more of it.
Right. Well, okay, so have either of you ever stopped to think that everything that's written in a horror book or everything that is portrayed in a horror movie actually came from somebody's head, from their thought process, that they took the time to take their mind to such a dark place,
right,
that they couldn't even think up this kind of stuff? Anybody thought about that?
I think about that a lot. Actually, one of my favorite authors is actually Stephen King.
Ah!
And I think about, but with Stephen King, I like Stephen King because he's not just scary. He's produced other things. Like one of my favorite books / movies is The Shawshank Redemption.
Okay.
I liked Misery. I liked The Green Mile. But
now you didn't think Misery was scary, because I saw Misery. And I watched it once and I'll never look at it again, because when she started sneaking up on him and banging his legs and stuff, I mean, that was like, it sent chills down my spine.
I didn't think it was scary. I just thought in my brain, I was just like, she's a fan, I get it. But like,
she's crazy.
You gotta cut his legs off and break him and things like that. Like, I didn't get that. But with Stephen King, it's just like, it's two sides to him. It's just like, I can give you things that, you know, are family friendly and something that you won't want to throw up or call on Jesus while watching. But
right.
Then in that same breath, it's just like, this man really sat down and wrote it about the clown. And it's just like, where is his mind going? Like, you
Where's
sit there and you think
from?
About that. Like, where is this coming? What person sits down and is just like, all right, I'm about to write a book and a movie about a killer clown, and he gonna only attack kids. And like, for me, it's just like, no, I gotta read this book. I gotta see this movie.
Wow.
Because like,
so do you feel like, Kaden, I'm gonna ask you, and I'm gonna ask you the same question, Michaela, do you feel like there should be any filters as it relates to the eye gates and the ear gates of a Christian? Or should we just allow anything in and just trust God to not let it impact us negatively? I'm going to start with Kaden.
I will have to go with your second answer. Your second answer.
Which was let everything in?
Yeah, and just let God, you know.
All right, Kaden. Let's hear your perspective on that.
Well, first of all, it's not really true, so.
I'm sorry, Kaden. You actually gave me your thought. I meant Michaela. But go ahead with what you were saying about it's not really true.
Michaela can go first, Tina.
Okay. Well, let me ask you, Michaela, real quick before you tell me about do you think it affects or should Christians allow everything in? You know, it doesn't matter, just everything in, even though it's the opposite of God, evil. And it goes against everything that God has told us to do and how he's told us to act and behave. We're watching things that are the opposite of that for entertainment. I want to know, do you think that there's any truth in all of this stuff, that these horror movies? Are there any truth?
This is for me?
Yes, for Michaela.
I feel like as not real as it is, in that same breath, you have to think about the people who produced it. It's just like somewhere down the line, in your subconscious, like maybe it was a series of events that might have happened in their lives, or maybe it's just, you know, they had, well, same thing, they had it that they were dealing with when they were younger. It's just like somewhere down in your timeline.
Yeah.
Like, that mindset just began to happen. So I feel like it is planted somewhere in them. Like, these events probably have happened, and then it's just like, okay, because I know that, you know, I can't do this stuff in real life, let me put it in a book.
Put it in a book. Put it in a movie.
Let me put it in a movie, because like, I do what I'm going to jail. But if I put it in a, if I put it in a movie, it's just like, It's really no harm out of it.
That's a really good point. They're able to fantasize and act out things that are really in their heart and their mind. Let me ask you, Kaden, you said that the movies make you feel anxious. What about, like, I know with me, years and years ago when The Exorcist first came out, I went to the movies to see it. I had to have the lights on a whole lot. Dark places, just, I was not comfortable for a long time. Do scary movies ever have those effects on you, where, you know, dark and being alone and, you know, hearing noises here and there in the house affect you differently right after you've seen a scary movie?
All the time. All the time.
Okay. Go ahead.
There was this one time where me and my grandmother, we went to go see The Boy at the movie theaters. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you, it was scary from my opinion. It was scary. And when I came home, it was like already dark time. It was like 7, 8. It was dark. And let me tell you, I couldn't sleep by myself. I really had to sleep with my grandmother or my mom. And I told her to usually put my the LED lights on, but low, mm-hmm. and she doesn't really, you know, sleep with the lights, because she says it brings the light bills up and stuff. And I was just really scared. And so when I usually sleep by myself, I would stare out of my room, just like at the hallway, just to see if anything comes up. Like, my mind would make scenarios or like thoughts of people just randomly coming up to me, like sleep. It's like, it's like really scary. And I'm like, I can't do this. So I'll just go in my mom's room and sleep with her.
But you keep watching scary movies, even despite the way it makes you feel.
What'd you say?
I said, so you keep watching them though, even though they make you scared of the dark and you have to sleep with somebody and all of that, which is uncomfortable. You know, in your home, you should feel peaceful and calm. But, you know, okay, I got your perspective. Michaela, I'm going to pose the same thing to you. What do you, do they make you feel any kind of way after you watch them?
Well, let me put it, when I was younger, because when you're young, you have that mindset of, you know, monsters are real. Somebody is coming after me if I cut these lights off. Somebody's gonna come after me if I don't light a candle while I'm getting ready to go to bed. But the older I got, it was just more or less of a mindset of, what are you afraid of? Like, when I watch them, it's just like, what am I really being afraid of? Because like we stated before, it's just like, these things aren't real. This clown is not real. Michael Myers is not real. And that's the mindset that I developed as I got older, to where literally I could go watch a scary movie and sleep like nothing's wrong. and not be and not be scared. But of course, when I was younger, it affected me. But now it's just like, okay.
Yeah.
What's the next one coming out? Like,
yeah. Yeah. Well, you know what? You both have proven some facts that our staff has uncovered. Our producers have uncovered facts regarding people being desensitized after watching so much killing, so much horror, playing the video games that kill, people getting desensitized so that it affects you one way when you're young, but then after years and years and years of watching it, it has an effect on you where it's like, I'm used to it now. It doesn't bother me. And so, you know, we're going to look into, is that a good thing or is that a bad thing? The whole purpose of this show is to decode it. So we're going to decode that. Did you all have any closing remarks that you want to say? You've been awesome. I've learned so much. Anything you'd like to say?
Yes, I just wanted to say thank you so much for having me on here. And I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. Thank you for being so honest with us. And listen, we're going to release you, but don't leave. I want you to watch the rest of the show because it's going to bless you. Michaela?
I just thank you for having me. I was really happy to be on here and share my thoughts with you guys.
Thank you so much. Both of these are women of God and we love them so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
God bless you too.
Wow. I'm telling you, these are young people that were very honest. They were very forthright. And we just thank God that they came on and they share it with us from their heart, how they feel about fear, how they feel about scary movies. And so now I think what we want to do is bring Stephanie back on. Stephanie, come on, because what I want to do is I want to start delving into some facts now. Some of the things that we have decoded as it relates to fear and the result it has, the effect it has on the human psyche. What'd you find out?
Yeah, so we had a study that surveyed 2,000 people, and it found that many adults remember watching their first horror movie at the age of 10. 10 years old.
10?
Yes, 10. And 52% of those people shared that the many things that scared them then still frightens them today. Yeah.
So some people it desensitizes, but then others, the fear remains consistent.
Yes, from a child all the way into their adulthood.
But they still enjoy
yes.
the scary movies.
Yes, yes. So then they had another 62% of people that admitted it can be fun to be scared, that it's fun. And then 47% said that these scary movies have later caused them to have nightmares.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so, of course, we know a nightmare is an interruption of sleep, mm-hmm. an interruption mm-hmm. of peace.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Fear.
Yeah.
Fear. They're chasing fear for a yes. thrill.
Yes.
Wow. Okay. Yes.
And also just wanted to throw at you, Dr. Golder, fear tactics in the church. And how sometimes we've used those fear tactics to get people saved or tell them if they don't do this, they're going to go to hell. Or those still fear factors affect people from yeah. young to old.
Yeah. A lot of people have said, you know, they don't come to church now. They're not saved now because they're fearful that if they make a little bitty mistake, they're going to go to hell.
That's
you
right.
know, that they can't be good enough to please God or for God right. to love them. And so, yeah, right. the church has even used fear factors.
Yes, that's right.
So I guess what we want to hit now is fear of God. How does God feel about fear? Did you have any other statistics that you wanted to spit out?
Or no,
was
ma'am.
That it? Okay.
It.
So now we're going to go into the biblical perspective, because, listen, we can't discern truth from a lie without going to the word. So Joel chapter 2 and verse 21 says, "Fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord will do great things." The first two words of that scripture, fear not. That's a direct command from God. Don't fear. And then it tells us what emotions we're supposed to embrace. Not fear, but we're supposed to embrace gladness. We're supposed to rejoice because we know that God is going to do great things. And then as we travel on to 2 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 7, it says, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear. Listen, fear didn't come from God. So if it didn't come from God, where did it come from? All fear rests in the hands of Satan. Satan is the author of fear. It said God hasn't given us that spirit, but he's given us. In other words, God has given us the spirit of power and of love and of a sound mind. You don't have a sound mind when you can't sleep at night. You don't have a sound mind when you're having nightmares. You don't have a sound mind when you can't have the lights off for fear something's going to get you. You don't have a sound mind when you have to sleep with somebody because you're so scared to sleep by yourself. That's not a sound mind. It's not of God. Finally, I want to take you to Philippians chapter 4 and verse 8. It says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of a good report. It says, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, what are we supposed to do? Think on these things. You won't find fear anywhere in any of these fruits that we just talked about. These are fruits of the Spirit. Christians are to operate in fruits of the Spirit. We must be very careful to guard our ear gates and our eye gates, children of God. You can't let any and everything in. It will consume you and it will push out the fruits of the Spirit. Evil cannot entertain the child of God. Can't entertain the child of God. So listen, if you love scary movies, I'm not judging you and I'm not putting you in hell. I'm just throwing out food for thought, food for you to hear truth from lie so that you can decode what you should be doing. All right? Listen, I want you to tune in next week for Hocus Pocus as we decode witchcraft. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. And remember to guard your mind. Don't let anything in until it is decoded. God bless you.